Hello, class. Here we have another example where we're going to look at 2D motion of a falling object, again with acceleration due to gravity. It reads as, a helicopter traveling horizontal is 80 meters above the ground when a relief package is released and leaves the helicopter with the same horizontal velocity as the helicopter. The package subsequently lands on the ground 100 meters horizontally ahead. What is the helicopter's velocity? Remember our steps for problem solving. We're going to identify the concepts that are involved here, set it up, solve it, and then we'll reflect on the answer. So let's sketch the problem. We've got a helicopter flying along. Here's my little helicopter. It drops a package. We're going to call that our t equal to 0 point, at which point the package is given this initial x velocity, the same as the helicopter. And the package is going to experience a downward acceleration due to gravity. And so it's going to move along uniformly in the x direction, but it's going to build up velocity in the y direction. And so we've got something that is going to And so we're going to build in a parabolic motion. We'll build a parabolic motion as such. And we know that the point at which it lands is 100 meters away from the point, the position where it was dropped. And it's fallen 80 meters in the process. And so we had an initial Vy naught equal to 0 and a downward acceleration. What is that going to look like on our position time graphs? We're going to start up somewhere here at 80 meters and we're going to fall towards the ground. At this point, we're going to hit the ground. And so we started up here with the Vy naught equal to 0. We'll have some other velocity here. So we've got a changing slope. The slope went from 0 to a higher velocity or a higher slope. And our x position, if we define this as our, and let me specify here that I'm defining my usual positive y and positive x. And we could do a number of other, we could define the axes differently, but I like to keep them the same way for most of my problems. We'll see later where we'll incline them, but otherwise I usually define positive y upward. So back to our position time graphs, we know that this then time, it's the Vy that buys us time, or more generally, it's the y motion that buys us time. So we don't have a Vy here, but we do have a y motion that we build up. So it's this time when it hits the ground that's going to restrict the how far it's gone. And we started out with an x position of 0 if we define its starting point up here as x equal to 0. And it went down here to an x position then of 100. What about our y? We can define this as the starting point at a positive 80 meters, and it's going to come down here to a y equal to 0. And so our x plot is going to look like this. A straight line, because we have a vx equal to a constant, and it's going to go to a maximum position where it hits the ground of 100 meters away from where it started. Let's take inventory of the parameters for our package. At t naught equal to 0, we had an x naught of 0 and a y naught of 80 meters. We had a vx that's equal to a constant, but it's unknown. And we had a vy naught that was equal to 0. We have no acceleration in the x direction, and we do have an acceleration in the y direction. It's our usual negative g. At time t, sometime later, when it hits the ground, we now have an x naught equal to 100 meters, and a y equal to 0. Our vx is constant, stays the same. Our vy now is unknown this time, and our acceleration we have already given. So looking at what I have, I'm interested in finding out the time. The time here is what restricts my motion, so I need to know something about my time. So if I want to determine which equations are needed, I want something that's going to work with my y position and time. I know my ay, I know my vy naught is 0, I know my y naught, and I know my y equal to 0. So that will give me a solution to my time. The second part of that problem then is going to be actually finding the velocity of the helicopter. And I know that vx is just related to my change in position over time. And I know my delta x, and I know my time from up above. So that should give me my helicopter's velocity, which is my vx component of my package, my original velocity. So I've carried those equations over here. So at t equal to tg, we know what the acceleration due to gravity is. We know that we've got a vy naught of 0. We know our initial position, and we know that when it hits the ground, y is equal to 0. And so I can rewrite this equation so that I've got 0 equals y naught plus 1/2 ay t squared. So I get this expression for the time, and I can solve, plugging in values now, negative 2 times my positive 80 meters and a negative or a downward acceleration of 9.8 meters per second squared. And I should note that since I'm doing the square root there, I've got a plus or a minus value that I'm going to be considering. And I get a value here of positive negative 4.04 meters or seconds, pardon me, seconds. Let's check those units in fact. So I've got meters on top, and I've got a meters per second squared. That leaves me with seconds squared, and I'm taking the square root of those. So then I'm left with a second. And of course, the one that I'm really interested here for the downward motion is the positive 4.04 seconds. The negative is a mathematical solution to that quadratic function that I saw, but the physical solution is in the positive side of the values. Lastly then, we want to use that time in order to solve for the velocity of the x component of the velocity, which was our initial velocity, which was also then the velocity of the helicopter as it moved horizontally. And so I've got my x position, which is 100 meters, minus x naught, which was 0, the t naught, or t is 4.04 seconds, and t naught is 0, and so I end up with a value. And so I end up with a value that is a positive 24.748 meters per second. In other words, to two significant digits, 25 meters per second.